Qué bonito es poder descubrir, gracias a la música, a gente tan humilde y mágica como estos irlandeses con los que nos hemos reunido esta tarde. Codaline, te lo creas o no, comenzó como una banda de instituto, una banda formada por un grupo de chavales que lo único que querían era hacer lo que más les gustaba. Tal vez esa pasión es lo que les ha hecho llegar tan lejos y ya conocidos incluso a escala mundial, gracias a temas que todos conocemos como High Hopes o el mítico All I Want. Y aquí están, a nada de lanzar nueva música y continuar con su magia. Hoy charlamos con ellos a puntito de lanzar su tercer álbum de estudio en una entrevista exclusiva a The Hall of Stars. Hoy conoceremos a Codaline de cerca.
Bienvenidos a España, muchísimas gracias por concedernos este ratito. Y ya falta nada, ya faltan muy poquitos días para que salga vuestro tercer álbum. Hemos tenido que esperar 3 años para que se lanzase. ¿Cómo ha sido esos 3 años?
The last 3 years have been pretty awesome. We've kind of been touring the whole time, but we did take a bit of time off. Two of the guys got married, Jay and Vinny, and I suppose real life got in the way. We released 2 albums and we just constantly toured for 3-4 years. So we worked with a lot of different people on this album, different producers. We've kind of changed our sound. We deliberately didn't want to make the same record again, and we wanted to get out of our comfort zone. So we're very excited about it. I'm very, very excited about getting back on the road. And more importantly, we're very excited about playing in Spain again.
Bueno, además, el álbum, si no me equivoco, debería haber salido el 10 de agosto, pero al final tuvo que retrasarse un poquitín y lo tenemos ahora en septiembre. Me suena que fue por una canción. ¿Qué pasó exactamente?
We felt that the album needed one more song. When you're making an album, there's so many fine, little finishing touches and stuff like that, and we just felt it was missing an extra track, so we felt, as much as we didn't want it, but we thought it was for the better to delay the album until that song was finished. And so that's what we had to do, and what we're very proud of.
Bueno, yo ya he tenido ocasión de poder escuchar este álbum. La verdad es que me ha encantado, me parece el mejor álbum que tenéis de los tres. Me recuerda un poquito al último trabajo, por ejemplo, de Imagine Dragons, o también los últimos álbumes de Coldplay. Está vuestro estilo, pero sí que notamos un cambio de sonido, ¿no? Por ejemplo, en uno de vuestros últimos singles, que es Follow Your Fire.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you very much.
Yeah. I mean, two great bands to be compared to them. Absolutely awesome. And we've always been influenced by Coldplay. Imagine Dragons, they've got some cracking tunes, big fans. So with Follow Your Fire, we did that purposely. We wanted to work with different people and change up our sound. To see where we could go, and that was us getting out of our comfort zone. We worked with a guy called Steve Mack, he was awesome. It was a really great experience to work with him, and we're very proud of Follow Your Fire. It's a song about, following your gut instinct and chasing your dreams and going out and doing it, even against all odds, when people are against you, they say you can't do it. So.
Y pronto, como me decíais, vuestros fans podrán escuchar ya esos álbumes en directo. ¿Tenéis ganas ya de esto? ¿Qué podrán encontrar vuestros fans en estos nuevos conciertos?
We're back on the 23rd of October in a place called La Riviera, which we've played before, and we absolutely love. And all this week we're personally going to meet our fans and to stand in the room with them and play them our new album, which is really, really, really scary. We did it yesterday in Zurich, and it's amazing to get like a direct response from the people that have made us what we are. So we're really happy to be back and to be doing this, but it's very scary. But I'm glad we're doing it, and I'll probably do it again.
¿Y qué es lo que sentís cuando subís un escenario como por ejemplo este verano, que habéis estado actuando en distintos festivales, y ver que todo el público sabe vuestras canciones y canta con vosotros? ¿Cuál es el sentimiento que tenéis ahí?
It's an incredible feeling, With our fans, even the new songs this summer, they've been singing back, which is absolutely mind-blowing, because some of them had only been out maybe a day or two. Like, we played a song called Shed a Tear at a Spanish festival. I think that was the first time we played it live ever. And by the last chorus, the audience was singing along. So, we've always had the fans like singing and interacting with us, but for them to do it on the new album is absolutely amazing. So really, really positive.
Pero para llegar a esto habéis tenido que recorrer la verdad un largo camino. De hecho, recuerdo que antiguamente no os llamabais Codaline, nos llamabais 21 Demand.
They were much smaller.
We don't.
Yeah.
We've chosen to forget those days. They were a lot smaller.
Well, yeah, it was, we were kids.
We were a teenage band. Yeah. We started that in school for a battle of the bands. It's kind of like everybody in the school was just kind of grouping together because there was a battle of bands coming up, which we actually organized because we love music.
And we fixed it,
so we won. But loads of our mates got into bands, and we started a band, and I think we're probably one of the only ones that stayed together out of all the bands. And kind of kept with it and started writing songs and really taking it seriously. We were playing covers back then for the most part, and like The Killers and stuff like that. Thin Lizzy was an Irish band, like all different types of music. It's really
exciting when you get into a room a quarter the size of this with your friends for the first time, and it's really, really loud,
and it sounds like.
Sounds awful. In your head, it sounds amazing. And, like one of the most exciting things you can do, I think, is start a band with your friends. So, yeah, from the age of 15, maybe.
Y también hace 6 años desde que sacasteis, yo creo, el single que os cambió un poco la vida, que es All I Want. ¿Consideráis este single un antes y un después en vuestra carrera?
Yeah, I guess so.
It was like All I Want was kind of the first song that really kind of got picked up by like radio and TV shows, and like all of a sudden we were in movie credits and in TV shows and stuff like that, and that kind of really like catapulted us, like, and the video for the song just kind of went viral, and we've kind of been chasing and following the success of that song kind of around the world. But yeah, like All I Want was the turning point that turned us into kind of like a band that played for fun into like a band that this is our job, this is what we get to do for a living.
También, para que no lo sepa, venís de Irlanda, uno de los países de Europa con mayor tradición musical, yo diría, donde encontramos grupos como, por ejemplo, U2. Supongo que grandes referentes, ¿no?, para vosotros.
Yeah, well, we've been lucky enough to actually meet U2 as well, which was amazing. I was invited backstage at a U2 show before, which was incredible, and I was chatting to Bono, and I didn't think I'd ever meet him again, but then we were all over in LA, and we were in the Fender guitar kind of workshop in Burbank, and they happened to be rehearsing next door, so we kind of put our heads together and started emailing people and asking management and asking our record company and everybody and anybody we knew. And we managed to get, asked them through somebody, I can't remember who it was, and they invited us in.
También el cariño que tenéis de vuestros fans de allí de Irlanda es impresionante. Yo recuerdo que os vi por primera vez en el Deco de un festival aquí en Madrid hace unos años y estaba por la primera fila. Recuerdo mirar atrás y ver la gente llena de banderas de Irlanda con muchos fans en ese concierto en Madrid. Os acompañan muchos fans, ¿no?, desde Irlanda a los demás conciertos y festivales que tenéis por Europa.
In the beginning, there used to be a lot more, but now the band has grown. It's kind of had fans everywhere, which is an absolute blessing. But there's still, you'll always spot an Irish person. I mean, if they're in Spain, they're going to be a little more sunburned than everyone
else. I think it's in the Irish. It's part of our culture to just kind of be really like, if you meet an Irish person, they're just straight away, they'll just start chatting. They'll be like, oh jeez, how's it going? But we can spot an Irish person from miles away as well.
Y también lo que me decías, creo que tenéis mucho cariño a España. Aparte de venir varias veces a nuestro país, también uno de vuestros últimos videoclips, el de Follow Your Fire, fue grabado aquí en España, en Barcelona. Tienes cariño, ¿no?, a nuestro país.
Yeah, we did. We love coming to Spain, and yeah, we shot Follow Your Fire on a rooftop in Barcelona. And we're going to play Barcelona as well on this tour in October.
So in
Razzmatazz. Spain has always been an incredible place for us. The fans have been so welcoming, and they've kind of really taken us underneath their wings. So it's we love coming here and playing festivals here, and then playing our own shows has been amazing. So yeah, we've got a lot of love for Spain.
y sé que ahora estáis en una época maravillosa y tal vez ni os lo planteéis, pero ¿pensáis que Codaline tiene fecha de caducidad?
No, never. Yeah, no, it's, I don't know, it's...
Every 10 minutes.
Yeah, like, yeah, the music industry is so fickle and kind of, you see bands come and go and stuff like that, but like we work quite close, and I think if we like stick together as a band and as four people, we can do this for the rest of our lives, you know. We're in a very fortunate position that like, yes, we get to release albums and we're releasing our third album, which is incredible. Like, you know, we didn't think that we'd get to release one album. So I think for us, like, yeah, this is it. This is all we kind of want to do. And I can't imagine us ever doing anything else other than being in Codaline.
Y si tuvieses ahora mismo la opción, chicos, de enviaros un mensaje a los Codaline del pasado y a los Codaline del futuro, ¿qué os diríais a cada uno de vosotros?
That's a good question.
Always, oh well. Younger self to you now.
And then you know to future self. Fuck.
Oh, there's a couple of haircuts and things I wore that I wouldn't have worn. I don't think you should like have too many regrets. Like I'm kind of happy with where I am. I don't know what I'd change.
Yeah.
Future self? I don't know. Fuck, that's a good. I've never been asked that question.
That's
before.
A great question.
That's incredible. That's a question you just kind of.
Get it.
We could spend a whole night. Take a couple of nights and really reassess everything.
God, I don't know. We'll come back to you on that because I have no idea. I don't have a good answer right now. It's a really good question.
No os preocupéis, chicos. Muchísima suerte con todo lo que os viene ahora y nos vemos en octubre con vuestro nuevo tour. Muchas gracias.
Thank you. We'll see you in October.
Sinceramente, no creo ni que haga falta que me llamen para saber qué se dirían a los Codaline del futuro. Ya lo digo yo. Seguid así. Seguid creando temas que emocionen, temas con los que muchos nos identifiquemos y, sobre todo, seguid creando vuestra magia. Nosotros seguiremos escuchándoos y emocionándonos con ella. Os aseguro que ha sido muy especial conocer a los chicos de Codaline de cerca.